the survival of the species threatened by bushfire and loss of habitat.
Fighting to stay alive.
Their habitat bulldozed for development.
Scientists say that the population in the state of New South Wales has decreased by up to 60% in the last 11 years.
It's no secret koalas are in trouble. And one-fifth of the state's koala population lives in this region.
Right next door to these pristine national parks, the state-owned forestry corporation has been convicted of felling trees vital to the koala's survival. The Forestry Corporation answers to three state government ministers, or it's supposed to anyway, and it's now facing multiple prosecutions over the destruction of koala habitat. That could see it fined millions of dollars.
The Forestry Corporation of New South Wales is an absolutely rogue and out of control agency or corporate entity.
Dylan Pugh has been fighting to save koala habitats for decades.
It wasn't identified as plantations. It's never been
identified. It doesn't matter what it was back then. They
And this is mapped as native forest on their website today.
He took us to the wild Cattle Creek State Forest, where tall stands of tallow wood and blue gum support the increasingly isolated koala population.
They pick certain trees that have, like, maybe low toxins in the leaves. The bigger the trees are, the more they use them. When we start taking them out, they can't maintain their population structure anymore. And here they are, obliterating their habitat.
It was in this forest that the Forestry Corporation ran foul of the Land and Environment Court. It was fined over $285,000 on charges which included felling four large trees in a koala exclusion zone. This reduced the size and the quality of the habitat available to the breeding female and offspring.
There's only four trees, and all around it, there were hundreds of koala fig trees logged within koala habitat.
The prosecutions are brought by the state's Environment Protection Authority, which means effectively, somewhat bizarrely, that one state body is taking on another government body. And there's nine more prosecutions in the pipeline. If they are breaches, the maximum penalty could be $2 million.
That's $2 million in each case, $18 million in total.
But the reality is that no matter what the financial penalty, once these forests are destroyed, as they are being, they're not coming back.
Mark Graham is an ecologist.
How are you?
2 years ago, he too came into conflict with loggers at Wild Cattle Creek.
Don't touch me, brother!
Hey, brother.
Andre!
Film it, man!
Hey, there's no need to violence, guys. Do you understand me?
These are literally amongst the most ancient of forests on the planet. They're islands in the sky.
Imagine our state without koalas. It could be a reality in less than 30 years.
That provoked a bold media announcement from the then Environment Minister, Matt Keane, saying he wanted to see their population doubled by 2050.
Is that commitment to be believed?
No, it's a slogan.
For 19 years, Catherine Cusack has served the Liberal Party in the New South Wales Parliament. In 2020, she voted against her own government's koala policies, which many viewed as a deal done by the then Nationals leader John Barilaro and the Environment Minister Matt Keane, who wanted to secure a commitment for net zero emissions.
He did say to me very specifically, decisions are made by doing deals.
Matt Keane denies any deal, but last week Catherine Cusack quit this parliament altogether, disgusted with the process and her own party.
A betrayal of trust, unethical, stupid. I mean, we've ended up now in the worst of all worlds.
She says taxpayers are forking out more than $200 million a year, most of it to subsidise forestry operations, rather than to protect the koala.
So for $200 million a year, we've basically kept afloat an unsustainable industry and put the koalas on a trajectory whereby they will be extinct.
Most of the koala feed trees in here have been cut down, and when they do retain them, then they go and damage them. You know, it's criminal. It's actually illegal to damage habitat trees.
If they were a private entity, they would have been drilled into bankruptcy ages ago. We're literally destroying the fabric of life, and the taxpayer of New South Wales is footing the bill to the tune of tens of millions of dollars every year.
The campaigners want the logging to stop.
Forestry is tiny. There are so few jobs.
They say many of the forestry workers left unemployed would be ideally suited for jobs in their proposed 300,000-acre Great Koala National Park.
For now, the logging continues, the prosecutions continue, and koalas remain on the road to extinction in New South Wales. Now, when it comes to the Forestry Corporation, there are two key ministers we think have questions to answer. The Agriculture Minister, Dougald Saunders, and the former Environment Minister, now Treasurer, Matt Keane. We've invited both of them to come on and defend their so-called rogue agency. Both have declined.
The only solution to this problem is to buy out the wood supply contracts, the agreements that the government has with private industry, and to shut down the logging of native forests forever.
You just think back to the bushfires and how heartbreaking it was to see all those habitats destroyed and see those poor, beautiful koalas, you know, fighting to have drink bottles of water and all that sort of stuff. It was so, so upsetting. And now this is two government departments that are fighting each other over logging. Like, it's just... it boggles the mind.
I don't think there's any disagreement that the koalas are worth saving. I think it'd be hard to find anyone in Australia that would say otherwise. But clearly the approach that we're taking is not producing the result that we all agree we want. I mean, I know the New South Wales state government's in a bit of a mess at the moment, but I do think these ministers probably have some answers. You know, do need to answer some of the questions. We've got statements from the Forestry Corporation, New South Wales, the EPA, and one of those ministers on our website if you want to take a look at them.